Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the second episode to create a static website using Bootstrap 4. In the previous episode, we imported Bootstrap 4 in our project. We also imported other necessary things like Google Font, Font Awesome, Custom CSS and Custom JS. Today, we'll be working on this header. Now let's get started, and the first thing I want to add is div id wrapper so that I can wrap everything inside it. So I want to add the header. Let's add a comment called header block as well. Then inside header I want to add the container div. Let's make it container fluid, and if you want to know the difference, then you can go to your Bootstrap's website. You can click on documentation and then click on layout grid, and if you search for the container fluid, then you will understand over here. So if we just use container, then it will provide the fixed pixel width over here. But if we use the container fluid, then it will provide the 100% width across all viewport and device sizes. So that's the reason I want to use this container fluid. So inside this container fluid, let's add the navbar, and navbar is a component. So click on this components link, and then you can click on this navbar. Here you can see different navbar designs, and you can choose the one which look best to your design. So I'm gonna use this one since it has got the logo text and the menu links. So if you compare it to our design, you can see the same over here as well, logo text and the menu links. Let's copy all of these codes now, and then you can add it inside this container fluid. Now refresh the site, and you should see the navbar component over here. If you want to remove this gray background, then it is coming from this BG light, so remove them and then refresh it. Bear in mind, you are seeing exactly the same style as in our design because we have already added all our CSS at the beginning of the project. But let's assume there is no CSS. So let's open this header.css and let's remove everything. Now refresh the site again, and this time it should look exactly as in our documentation over here. But since we got our own design, we must add our own CSS to make it pretty. Now it's time for us to work on the actual logo text and the menu items. So open your index.html, and then instead of navbar, you can call it corporate. Then the first nav link is home, that's fine. The second one is about. Third one is services. You can remove the disabled link, and let's copy any one of the link. Works, theme, and finally let's add contact. Now refresh the site again, and then you should get exactly the same header as in our design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on the hero carousel. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.